Hey guys, I'm Meg from PMTVUK and I'm here today with Bryan from Dunlop. Now, I am the acoustic person for PMT, so
yes.
My world is roots, blues, folk, Americana, and for years
That's a great world.
Oh, it's a great world. But I was so scared of pedals. I thought that was an electrics world.
Ah.
And my world was acoustics, microphones, and that was it. It wasn't until I started playing around with pedals for live shows that I got totally hooked. But I know a lot of people like me that play acoustics don't really know where to start with it. So I thought we could go through a little rig rundown for an ideal pedal setup for live shows for acoustic players like myself.
So what we have here is an array of pedals here that will help solve problems for the live acoustic player.
Yep.
Not so much adding so much sauce that it's taken over a bunch of the sound, but actually solving real world application problems for
acoustic
roots Americana.
Yeah.
Acoustic.
Especially because a lot of people with acoustic guitars, you have a lot of pride in the guitar you've chosen and because of the sound it has.
Right.
If you plug into a DI, a venue's speakers, it's gone. That
it's
tone's
like,
gone.
It's like when you hear yourself recorded, you hear your voice
you're like, I don't sound like that.
Because the acoustic guitar is resonating with your body the same way your voice is resonating in your head.
Yeah.
So then when you hear it back, you're like, I don't sound like that.
It's always too thin always struggle with feedback. And
so that's why we selected these in particular to address those issues.
Yeah. Should we start with this one here?
Okay, so that is the bass preamp. Yeah, I said bass. We found out that this worked really great with acoustic instruments, not just guitar, but like mandolin and things like that, for a couple of reasons. First of all, sometimes you can't get the right input volume to the board.
Right.
So that addresses that issue. And then there's a bass and a treble knob that kind of roll off the bass and the treble. But the thing that is great about this one in particular, it has a semi-parametric mid. So you can pick the mid frequency that you want to cut or boost.
Yeah.
So that's those two knobs. And then there is a ground lift, and then there's a pre and post for the EQ, which that's kind of a deeper dive. But go ahead and play a little bit, and I'll play it up, turn it on. You'll hear how it kind of brings everything up. All right, so let's here it is, all bypassed.
Yeah.
Which sounds great. Now, we're gonna have a little more beef in here. To point out, as you well know, from room to room and stage to stage, you're going to need to bump up the bass, or you're going to need to bump up the treble or cut the treble. The parametric mids is an amazing feature so that you can really isolate those frequencies, and you have a direct out, an XLR out right to the board, so you have more control on stage than the jerk behind the soundboard.
That's always the problem, really.
I'm trying to especially the more he drinks, he or she. So if you don't mind, I would like to bounce over to the compressor.
Yes, sounds good.
Which is another thing. I'm gonna turn off the bass preamp. Now the studio compressor is based on the 1176 rack studio compressor that is, you know, a recording staple. It has the release, attack, input and output gains, and then the different ratios. We did a little secret sauce before you guys got here. What's it gonna do? It's gonna kind of round everything up a little bit. So the notes are kind of pop up a little bit, it'll smooth those downs.
Yeah.
The ones that are not coming in so much, but it just gives you a nice buoyancy. Go ahead and play a couple chords, bypassed. And then here it is, engaged. That might be a little loud, okay. So it's giving you a little more buoyancy. You feel it's a little easier to play. You're not digging in so hard. You have to be careful with compression because it will accentuate the feedback.
Mm.
Now, let's say you got some feedback. You got your compressor rolling.
Yep.
You got your bass preamp going. Go ahead and play. So there's that one note that's starting to take off. Let's see if we can really make that accent. There it is. Okay. So we did a little bit, you were here, we isolated that frequency. I'm gonna turn on this 10-band EQ and we're gonna knock those frequencies back so that you still get that nice full-bodied sound, but without the annoying feedback. Go ahead. So there's 12 bands here. You can figure out where those feedback, and maybe you don't like that top end. Let's bring back some of that top end. Warm it up a little bit. And then, you know, for other sauce, we'll leave the preamp on. I have a reverb here, and I have it set to, let's go start with the plate. Go ahead and play a little bit. Just a little bit of sauce. What is it? Dunk.
Yeah.
And then, you know, if you want to get real spacey, here's the epic, which is going to be a very long delay. And the angels are crying.
That's nice.
And if you need a little bit of movement, a little analog chorus. Have fun. Turn them all on.
Everything on.
And then
turn them all off. Yeah, great. Oh wow, nowhere near as fun to play.
It feels different, right?
Yeah, you get so much more life from your playing with it all on.
And then you got to add a delay.
That's one thing I've just dabbled
into.
Delays. Mm. Yeah, that's great. One thing I've always struggled with on stage was feedback, and then feedback affects your playing.
Oh yeah.
And then your whole set is.
Well, because you're playing now, you're playing scared.
Yeah. Or like.
And you can't let go.
You avoid notes, or you have to hold back on the bass.
So if you can isolate those frequencies.
That's it. Have.
And this will do that as well to an extent, but you can really find the frequencies with the 10 band, but also you can cut those mids that are kind of howling with the bass preamp as well.
Yep.
And you know what? Don't be afraid, vocalist, use the pedal board. Get your own reverb, get your own delay in there. Hey, I want a slap back delay. How's this sound? Check, check,
oh, yeah.
Check, check. No, you ever listen to the Beatles? Bap, 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 bap. Then you don't have to argue with the guys anymore. And then they'll take the XLR out. Mm. You got your own reverb, you got your own slap back delay. It's a lot of fun.
Game changer. Game changer.
Well,
maybe.
You know, you want to have more control over your art.
Yeah.
Than some schmuck.
Yeah, the more control you have, the better you'll play. The more you'll enjoy your gigs. The
more confidence.
The more the audience will enjoy your gigs.
Take your vitamins.
Yeah.
Wait.
Bryan, thank you so much. I think that couldn't have been more interesting for me.
You rule.
Thank you.
Thank you.
You rule.
Your playing was quite lovely.
Thank you very much. But yeah, if you want to find out any more information about any of these pedals, you can head to our website, pmtonline.co.uk, or you can head over to Dunlop and explore the whole range of MXR pedals. It's a whole crazy world that you should definitely look into. Thank you so much.
It's fun.
Thank you.